about all the coordinates from some point to the infinity, because the such sets form the form a basis of neighborhoods of identity. So this statement is clearly true for this example, because the quotient group is simply the final product of two element groups, which is fine. Okay, so yeah, and the proof of this theorem goes through functional analysis, and that's why I decided to present it here. Okay, so but let me first just make some remarks, because there is also a linear part of the proof, and I don't want to. So I'll just mention this part, and then we'll use it as a diagnosis in the proof. So we would like to have find a closed normal subgroup inside a given neighborhood of the identity. So in other words, what is the concept of closed normal subgroup? It's a kernel of some homomorphism from group G to some other group. So we would like to thank you. the integral of this function should be still equal to the integral of f. So we would be very happy if this could be named a constant function, right? So we would create constant functions. But this cannot be named a constant function in general. On the other hand, it can be made arbitrarily close to a constant function. So epsilon, so it's totally bounded, and in the this space, so indeed it's not bounded. Okay, so now that every Schmidt operator is compact, so we can use this to study the structure of the self-adjoint of our Schmidt operators. Self-adjoint means that A equals A star, or equivalently for every attention. Okay. lambda times expression here.